This is still the day of the Lord. This is still the day that we've been talking about the last couple of days, the day of deliverance, the day of clarity, of insight, of strength. And again, a lot of us, we are at the point of making a decision. We are faced with this path that has already been made clear to us. There's a scripture I woke up with this morning, Philippians chapter 3, and it talks about putting aside and leaving behind and forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward unto the things which are before us. And it encourages us to press toward the goal. Whatever your goal is, you press toward that goal. Interestingly, at this point, we are asking questions. We're still concerned. There's some of you who are some people have talked to me just feeling depressed, still concerned. What decisions do I make? Do I move forward? Do I stay? There's always this sense of worry, this sense of fear. But guess what? The path has already been made. The path has already been made. And like we talked about a couple of days ago, change that we've been asking for is here. It has taken place. It is more subtle. It's deeper. It's within, because we're asking again to go beyond our mind and go beyond our intentions and our imagination, so we can step into that place of vision. So as we move forward, we have the confidence that this path has already been made. There's a scripture where the Lord says he has gone before us and he has made the crooked path straight. So we will see the changes within ourselves. We'll see that outward expression in our relationships, career-wise, every area that concerns you. We'll see the perfection of that. And again, for some of you who are at that point of still questioning, you see the path, you're still looking up, you're questioning, I'm telling you, it's time to move forward. Interestingly, there's a scripture with Elijah, the prophet in the Bible, where God took him to a place of provision. God provided everything he needed, yet the time came when it all dried up. Then it was time for him to move. Then he got the next step, the next instructions. What should I do next? We're asking now. Well, honey, it's time to move forward, and it'll be made clear to you as you make this move forward. And God didn't tell us change is here for us to stand still. Go on, move on. It will become more clear to you. This is not your stopping place. This is not your stopping place. There's greater ahead. The light will unfold. And another thought that came to me is that for a lot of us, it's a time of ending. And with ending, sometimes it's painful. Here comes the worry. Here comes the fear. But guess what? With the end means new beginning. This is a time for the new beginnings for our lives. I welcome you into this day. Our angels have been waiting for us to enter into this day with joy, knowing that that which we have planted will now produce goodness and the success that we're asking for. Again, if your brook has dried up, honey, it's time to move forward. Even with the, I'm not sure how this is going to work out, move forward. Even with the fear, move forward. Even when it doesn't feel complete, move forward. The path will be made clear to you. Welcome to this day. This is that new day.